Howdy guys and gals, I'm Kyle Broderick. Welcome to the Social Regressive. Today's test is kind of a combination of a whole bunch of things that we've done in the past. We've made 6.5 Creedmoor subsonic ammunition. We have tested out 308 subsonic ammunition to see what kind of damage that we can do. And we've been testing out this rifle right here. This is the CMMG Mk3 DTR2, a fantastic rifle, as you've been seeing in some of the challenges that we've been doing, where we've been shooting moving targets. We've been shooting at 1,000 yards. We've been shooting at a mile. And we've done some kind of mixed targets at various distances to see how quickly we can get from target to target with a semi-automatic rifle like this. So again, 6.5 Creedmoor, heavy barrel. And what I'm really curious about today, since we are shooting 6.5 Creedmoor 140 grain spire-point subsonics through this, those are bullets from Speer. And you can go back and check out the video that I did showing how I created these. It's using Trail Boss powder and a couple little tricks that I had to do in order to get these to be kind of consistent and stable. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna do that same destruction testing. I have the same setup as last time with 308, and we're going to be hitting this steel popper target right here and then shooting through that pan into the water jugs on the other side. And we found out in the previous test that 22 long rifle, it didn't really move that popper at all. The 308 sure did, it knocked it back a little bit. Nothing quite like a supersonic would, but the 22 did pierce that pan. So we're not gonna revisit that. I'll just show you the little video right here. But now we're just gonna go ahead and take some shots with this and we'll see what kind of mess we can make. And this rifle is really heavy. I wish that I could have taken some of the stuff off it. We have the Bushnell HDMR2 previously reviewed. Awesome scope, just love the scope. Right now I don't like the scope because it's heavy. It's definitely set up for prone rifle shooting. And then I have the bipod way out here on the front that you can't really take it off because it's not quick detach. I'd have to undo it. It's kind of a pain in the neck. And then a heavy stainless barrel on here, which is why we get so much accuracy out of this rifle. But today it's working against me. This is not a rifle I've ever wanted to shoot offhand. Well, here we go. That's right, I forgot. These are subsonics, so they don't have enough gas pressure to actually open the bolt. Gotta manually do it. Now this does have a tunable gas block in here. It's not adjustable on the fly. You have to use some wrenches to get at it, but we could possibly open this up enough that the subsonics would cycle it. But then if we were to run supersonic ammunition through it right after, it would probably destroy some things. All right, let's go ahead and take that second shot. All right. And you know what? Since that was kind of a low shot on the popper, I'm gonna take one more. I forgot to adjust since we're so darn close. I need to hold about 8 milliradians high with this scope. So let's do one more. There we go. That moved it a little bit. Here's the mess. I think this was that second 6.5 Creedmoor impact. So that was pretty high up on it. Good splatter going on there. And then here's our hit on the pan. Okay, so there, that's the new hole that we cut through there. So not too far off center. Not too bad considering how heavy the rifle was I was shooting. All right, and we missed this jug entirely. We went right over the top. This one was just a stand for this one, basically. And now let's see if we can find these jugs. All right, so here's number one. There is the entry wound. Big old exit wound right there. This is really similar to what I see when I shoot a 75 grain boat tail hollow point from Hornady through my 223. All right, let's see if this thing started to open up. Oh yeah. So this is not the same kind of entry hole right here. That is ragged, big mess. And then the exit is splitting this bottle open even more. Look at that, it just tore it right up to the neck. Good grief, that's a lot of energy. Final bottle. Oh, hey, we have a bullet. We have a bullet trapped in here. I'm gonna take this to the car so we can check it out. This is why people shoot Speer Hot-Cor bullets. It looks like most of that bullet is still in there. Let's find out. All right. So we have one little petal that sheared off. And then we have, oh, this is pretty light. Oh, there we go. This is just the jacket. It looks like the core tore through and kept going. Cool. You can see that it mushroomed really well. Yeah, that's definitely gonna cut some things up. That's gonna make a big mess. Speaking of a big mess, here is the jug that was just shot. This is the third one. Big ol' entry wound. I can feel the exit. The exit is quite small, so I guess that's where the core tore through. There's no lead inside this bottle as far as I can see. It looks like it came out as one mass right out the back. And not too shabby. Consider that. That is about 18 inches of water that it went through. It mushroomed nicely. And yeah, the core still made it all the way through. I think today's video should dispel any of the misconceptions that we've had about subsonic ammunition. When we hear about it, it sounds like it's kind of silly. Like it's just kind of a range toy. It doesn't make any sense. It's not really gonna do anything. It's like shooting airsoft. And no, it's not like that at all. This can make quite a mess. You can see that, okay, if you consider the fact that these bullets weigh 140 grains, which is just a little bit less than what a heavy 9mm weighs, and those are also subsonic, usually when they're that heavy, then yeah, this is definitely a deadly serious thing going on here. And because it has those slicker bullets, it's actually going to have a better trajectory than a 9mm would, of course. And with the setup of this bullet and its spire point, I think it'll be very effective against, you know, things like coyotes. If you need to be discreet, if you need to be quiet, say you've had some kind of varmint coming around your barn messing with your chickens or something, great quiet way to deal with it. Your neighbors won't even notice. Really, really quiet. Today we weren't shooting without a suppressor, or with a suppressor. This was just with the muzzle brake. That's why I have my hearing protection on right now, actually. And you can still see that, you know, it was pretty quiet. I could have shot this without it, but it's still like shooting a 22, and I want to save what's left of my hearing. But yeah, we have a whole bunch more challenges coming up. Make sure you subscribe to The Social Regressive. We have shot all kinds of challenges where we have tested out, we've done kind of these sound tests where we have shot 22 long rifle, 223 supersonic, 223 subsonic, 6.5 Creedmoor supersonic. We're doing 308 subsonic. And now we're getting into 6.5 Creedmoor subsonic. I wanna hear what these bullets sound like as they go past the camera, go past the microphone, because it really is interesting to hear that Hollywood pew sound that appears when you get to certain distances. Usually it kicks in at about 100 yards, 150, 200, and you really get that pew sound as the bullet goes by. It's really cool. And I am still curious to find out, you know, at what point it appears with different bullets, and what might be causing it. Is it a standing wave behind the bullet? Is it a hollow point? And the two that we've tested most recently, 308 Winchester and now 6.5 Creedmoor, those will kind of get rid of the hollow point idea if we still do hear that pew sound. Thanks a bunch to patrons of the Destructive Arts for making tests like this possible. Like that video where I showed how I put together these subsonic loads in the first place. Make sure you check that out. I'll link to it around here somewhere. And yeah, that's gonna show how I actually put this together. There's a censored version on YouTube because they've been kind of cranky lately about reloading stuff. Everybody's kind of scared they're gonna get their videos taken down. And I have the uncensored version out on my Patreon page. So yeah, go to Patreon if you wanna get involved and if you wanna see some behind the scenes content. I have all kinds of neat stuff out there and some great people that are helping me figure out what to test, for one thing. They come up with some of these challenges, like multi-distance, moving targets, and then, you know, I try to figure out how to make those ideas happen. It's really nice to have a bunch of good people that I can talk to. Yeah, check us out there, and as I said, make sure you subscribe so that you see the upcoming videos. They're gonna be pretty exciting.
Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, be sure to like, share, and most importantly, subscribe. Even if you didn't like this particular content, go ahead and subscribe. There's probably something coming that's more up your alley. Check out this playlist right here. This is going to have videos in a similar vein to what you just watched. These two videos we cherry-picked for you. And finally, The Social Regressive is on Patreon. So, you can become a patron of the destructive arts and earn some goodies while helping us to provide high-quality videos just by kicking us a few bucks a month. Thanks a bunch for your patronage.